There it is again. Or maybe you're not sneezing, but itching all over. Whoa, is your face just swollen up to twice its size? Well, you might be allergic to something.
My lips don't normally look like this.
But could you be allergic to everything? Get your EpiPens ready because we're going to find out. This is your body on being allergic to everything. This is Ross Dethick. This British boy is allergic to almost everything. He carries an EpiPen wherever he goes. Ross is allergic to dairy, nuts, fruit, and most vegetables.
Eat it!
You're killing him, Michael!
Eating any of these foods will make his stomach sore and cause a rash. He survives mostly on ground beef and potatoes. He has severe asthma and eczema. His parents are constantly dusting, cleaning, and washing to help keep his allergies in check. His condition is extremely rare, but there are various allergies that would be life-changing. How would these allergies affect you? And how would you deal with them? More than 50 million Americans deal with allergies. The most common include hay fever, dust, insect stings, and certain foods like nuts, milk, shellfish, and eggs.
Is your tongue swelling up?
Either that or my mouth is getting smaller.
Most people deal with these by avoiding them or taking medication. But there are numerous, less common allergies that would be difficult to manage. Water. If you had aquagenic urticaria, you would suffer from painful, itchy hives whenever you came into contact with water. You couldn't take a shower, wash dishes, or even stand in the rain without developing painful welts. There's no effective treatment, although antipruritic lotions or creams can help soothe the itching.
Don't make the water too hot. The scabs come right off.
Sunlight. Exposing large areas of your body to sunlight could cause nausea and lightheadedness if you had solar urticaria. Stepping into the sun would first cause your skin to itch, followed by a rash and possibly hives. Just being outside would make you sick to your stomach. Antihistamines and sunscreen would help, and although there's no permanent cure, the condition can go away on its own.
Yes! Nighttime.
Exercise. For a rare few, exercise-induced anaphylaxis and urticaria is a possibility.
I am allergic to exercise.
If you suffered from this, you could go into anaphylactic shock simply by being physically active. Anaphylaxis causes lightheadedness and a narrowing of the airways. You could collapse. It could even be life-threatening.
My nipples, it's starting.
It is usually caused by vigorous exercise, but it can happen during any physical activity. Even something as simple as raking leaves. Certain foods can also be a contributing factor.
Don't put me down for cardio.
Heat. If you had cholinergic urticaria, you would suffer from hives brought on by raised body temperature.
I'm hot.
Although this would typically be from exercising and sweating, it can also be caused by taking a hot bath.
Got them all.
Eating spicy food, having a fever, or getting very angry. Certain medications like aspirin and anti-inflammatories could also trigger a reaction. So could humidity and hormonal changes.
This could be the sickest tan ever.
Money. If you develop a rash on your hands after handling coins, you could be allergic to nickel sulfate. You would also need to avoid contact with jewelry, hairpins, the metal parts of clothing, lighters, and even some door handles. You couldn't even carry change in your pockets. Touch. One of the most important connections we make in life is the human touch. If you had dermographism, the touch of others would cause an allergic reaction.
Don't touch me.
Also known as skin writing, you could write on your own body. Lightly scratching your skin would cause it to redden into a raised welt similar to hives.
It doesn't hurt at all. It kind of feels warm and itchy.
This would usually disappear within 30 minutes. And although the cause isn't known, it could be triggered by infection, emotional upset, or medications such as penicillin. Thankfully, these allergies are rare and most have some form of treatment or control. But would it be possible to live a normal and happy life if you were allergic to almost everything?
Yeah! I feel amazing!
Well, Ross Dethick is living proof.
Stay cheerful.
Yep.
Allergy UK nominated him to take part in the Queen's Baton Relay for the Commonwealth Games, and he joined a 5-kilometer exercise bike ride to raise money for the charity. With proper medical care and careful consideration of your environment, you could lead a pretty normal life.
Don't get slowed down by a little sickness.
Now, if you think allergies are bad, what if you couldn't sweat?
I feel fine.
Well, we'll find out what happens on another episode of Your Body On.